your favorite scary movie.
Welcome to the Bad Meets Evil Halloween Countdown Special, only on Shade 45.
Yo, what up? This is Evil.
And what's up? This is your man Bad, one quarter of the Slaughterhouse Machine, one half of the Bad and Evil Regime. And right now...
All right, we don't need the whole long speech about who you are and all that shit. We should just talk about, like, our favorite, like, Halloween theme songs and shit. Let's not make this, like, a long, drawn-out thing. I don't think it should be that. I mean, sometimes it calls for that, you know what I'm saying? But other times, I don't think, like... I think that people, by now, they probably know who you are. You know what I'm saying? So...
Well, why don't you spearhead this, then, Evil?
No, fuck that, man.
I'll follow your lead.
Maybe I don't feel like it.
I'll sit in the backseat. It's already bad enough that you're more famous than me, so the least you can do is let me fucking talk.
Go ahead, man.
Nah, man, you hurt my feelings.
Nah, say whatever you want. Nah, go ahead. Go say the whole Slaughterhouse again.
I forgot regime. When we were supposed to.
I like
to
the regime thing. Like when you say that, that shit sounds crazy.
That's my thing, and don't steal it.
Okay,
don't steal it. So what do we got to do?
This is the Bad Meets Evil Shade 45. Our top favorite Halloween theme-ish, squeamish, regime-ish songs that we picked, we hand-selected, or I selected, not I, meaning me, but I, like, with our eyes, selected that shit.
And if you're listening to this and you feel like that we're not very good at this, so what? We can rap.
It's because we're not.
So what's the first song we're going into?
The first song is Big L, Devil's Son.
Rest in peace. Right here on Shade 45.
Yo, yo, yo. Yeah, okay. I'm not really good at this, but yo, fuck it. I'ma wing it. My name is Marshall. Welcome back. That was Devil's Son, Big L. We're counting down right now. Our unlucky 13. Are we calling it that? That's corny as fuck. Yo, we're calling it the spooky fucking...
Our unlucky 13 Halloween-themed hip-hop records.
Regime-ish. Squeamish, regime-ish hip-hop records. Hold on, Reef is writing something down for us so we can say it, because he wants us to say something. It's probably going to be stupid, but... yeah.
What's the next joint that we going into, Evil?
I don't know, man.
How about D12? Shout out to D-Twizzy. How about D12 Devil's Night?
Okay, let's get into that. Then we'll get into day-to-day nightmares.
Right here on Shade 45.
Okay, yeah. Okay, Reef, quiet. Just hold on. We're back on the air right now. I'm trying to get this guy to shut up. First of all, I'm not really good at doing this anyways. So it's bad enough you gotta fucking make me nervous. That was Dana Dane Night. No, that was...
Yeah, what? Yeah. That was Dana Dane Nightmares and D12 Devil's Night.
Oh, we played them both in a row. I wasn't listening. I had to go take a shit. When we came back, I didn't know what...
You know what?
That's scary.
When you're not good at doing this shit, you can always clean it up by giving shout outs. So shout out my man Yellow Wolf.
Yeah. Yo, the really shout cool out. Thing about having your own radio station is you can fuck up as many times as you want, and they can just clean it up and make you look like a fucking, like the coolest guy in the fucking world.
That's a good idea that Paulie just made. I'm going to be Freddy Krueger.
For Halloween?
Yeah.
And what are you going to be for Halloween?
Eminem.
How the fuck is that going to work out for you? How's that gonna work out? You gonna go trick-or-treating? I dare you.
Yeah, I haven't taken my fucking mask off yet, though. It's 365 days. Huh?
What's it gonna be Freddy Krueger? You should be Candyman.
I got a performance, so I'm gonna be Gucci Krueger.
Gucci Krueger.
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna be Candyman. Get it? Eminem, Candy. Oh, wait, hold on. Yellow Wolf wants to... Hold on. I think he's chiming in.
He's wearing Scooby-Doo's right now.
Yellow Wolf literally looks like Shaggy right now from Scooby-Doo. We did a photo shoot today.
I'm Matthew McConaughey, bitch.
And I don't know what he just said. He said he's got Catfish Billy.
Catfish Billy.
Yeah, and he's...
You're right.
He's got tiger blood and all kinds of other shit. Something, I don't know. He's saying a bunch of shit in the background, but it's really not important right now. What's important is that we get into DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince. There's a nightmare on my street.
Right here on Shade 45.
Yo. All right, we're back here on Shade 45. That was DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince. Nightmare on my street.
Yes.
One of my favorite songs of all time, especially Halloween, theme-ish, squeamish, regime-ish songs. But yo, I think we want to bring Yellow Wolf right now to do this next segment.
Get him, Wolf. Get him, Wolf.
Because I think I got to go take a shit again, so.
Yeah, thank you.
Hey, how's it going, Yellow?
I'm chilling, man. So, what number are we?
13. We're doing our third, just so you know, before I leave, we're doing our 13 favorite Halloween theme-ish songs or whatever.
Theme-ish, theme-ish, squeamish, regime-ish.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is Pop the Trunk.
Wait a
Pop
minute,
the Trunk is up next.
No, we're supposed to be doing
Halloween songs, man. That shit is whack. What are you talking about?
Unless you pop the trunk on Halloween.
That's
you?
Your favorite record. You know every word of that record.
Pop the Trunk?
Pop the Trunk is up next. Right
Don't
here on Shade 45.
Me go pop
no, it's
the trunk
not.
On you. All right, look, man, we got to go into DMX, Damien. All right, come on, man, you can't fuck up our
Why
flow.
Why don't you? I'll tell you
this
what.
Show sucks.
you leaving now?
Fuck you guys.
When you the day you make a Halloween song, my friend, you might make it to this countdown.
It's 3 a.m. in the morning.
Scary.
Oh, wait. Hold on. Wait. Is one of my songs on here, though? I believe it is. Oh, hold on. Wait. Hold. Stop the presses. Hold on.
I got some shit on there. You better get with that Halloween rap, man.
Get that Halloween paper.
Yeah. Get that Halloween paper.
So let's go into DMX Damien right here on Shade 45.
All right, my name is Marshall. We're back right now on Shade 45. Right here on Shade 45, we're back. Exactly right here in this spot. Right here, and that was... What song was that?
I'm a much better host than you, by the way.
Go ahead, man. Take over.
So that was DMX Damien right here on Shade 45.
Me and Marshall... I didn't know what song it was because Reef scribbled it out.
Because you keep going to take
so
a shit?
So I didn't know that...
Marshall and I have a project out in stores right now called Bad Meets Evil, Hell the Sequel.
Oh, but y'all can promote.
Yes. Yes.
Yellow Wolf's album is not coming out, by the way.
November 21st, my album drops.
November 21st, Yellow Wolf's album will come out as long as he squeezes a Slaughterhouse Yellow Wolf collaboration about Halloween.
Yeah, I tried to make that happen, by the way. They all got drunk and left the studio.
Damn.
That's not true. That's not true.
That's really unprofessional if that's what happened. And I gotta say, I'm really fucking let down right now. I'm really disappointed.
You don't look disappointed.
I told you guys.
I'm really not disappointed. I don't. I really just don't care about nothing.
Song is fucking dope. Half the verses are done.
Yeah, me and Crooked.
Sorry. Show song. You supposed to go first.
All right. You guys are making me want to drink right now.
Oh, yeah, we don't want to do that.
Drinking is bad.
Drinking is bad. Let's change the subject.
All right, look, man.
What's the next
song?
What's the next record?
The next record that we hand-selected was Dr. Dre and Ice Cube, Natural Born Killers. We hope that you are enjoying this very spooky, spooky Halloween right here on Shade 45. So that... Wait, he just scribbled it out. Now I can't fucking read it.
Reef is fucking killing it right now, man. You're doing a hell of a job, man.
The song you just heard that went off was Dr. Dre and Ice Cube, Natural Born Killers. And next, we're going to get into the most amazing song ever wrote.
Kill My Nightmare.
You should let me intro this one, because if you intro it yourself, it's going to make you sound vain. So let me alley-oop you with this one.
The most incredible song ever wrote.
Pop the Trunk.
Pop the Trunk right here on Shade 45.
The next song is my good friend Eminem, 3 a.m. 3 a.m. in the morning, something about bodies being all over the place and he killed him. Right here on Shade 45.
Don't act like you don't know the fucking song by heart. 3 a.m. in the morning, right here on Shade 45. Now you got me saying right here on Shade 45. Alright, yo, we're back. That, my friends, was 3 a.m. in the morning.
Yes. Accents. In abundance.
With accents.
In abundance.
In abundance. Because you demanded them. They're back.
You, the people, demanded them.
Remember the time you said you were roasting marshmallows and you roasted your wiener?
No, I don't remember that, actually.
That was on the 4th of July.
That was really awkward.
You might want to take that part out.
No, I'm saying that was awkward when you told me that story. I was fucked up because that shit made me real uncomfortable.
Set you real
Do we sound like Beavis and Butthead right now? Do you get, you got a Halloween story, Em?
Yellow Wolf's got one.
We used to snatch bags.
Well, last year, Halloween fell on a weekend.
Good segue. Woo!
Yeah. Me and 5'9 were trick-or-treating. This right here is Ghetto Boys. My Mind's Playing Tricks on Me. Another one of my favorite songs of all
time.
Yeah,
mine's too. Right here on Shade 45. And we're back.
Right here live on Shade 45, Yellow Wolf is about to tell us a Halloween story.
This had better fucking be good, man, because this is our show.
Tales from the White Side. Take one.
Tales from the White Side.
No, actually, man, that title fits because I, you know.
Do you really got a Halloween story?
Halloween stories aren't really funny.
Last year, my friend and I, Royce, dressed up as, I dressed up as an ironing board, and he dressed up as an iron, and we did the same thing. Yeah, that's really weird.
That's a little gay.
That actually was not funny either.
Why do you gotta trump everything we do?
No. I said we went out as ironing.
Yeah, he went out as ironing.
Yeah, he went out as ire knee. We went out as ironing. Like the actual act of iron.
Next one.
Anyways, hey! So. Crickets.
Hey, next song.
So, yeah. Okay, we've got a special treat for you, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to play two songs in a row and not talk in between them.
They're going to love that.
Yes. The next two songs coming up are the next two songs coming up are Grave Diggers, Diary of a Madman, and Kanye West, Monster.
Yes, right here on Shade 45.
Hey, yo, we're back.
Right here on Shade 45. My name is Bad. His name is Evil. Royce da 5'9", Eminem, Slim Shady.
Yeah, I don't really have too much else to say. I'm running out of shit to say. I'm really like...
You know what we can do? We can go into the next song.
Okay.
Because you gotta let them know what we're doing. We're counting down our top 13.
Yeah. For those of you who have just joined us, who are fortunate enough to have just joined us and not listened to all that other bullshit, if you're just tuning in and you're just fortunate to only catch these last couple of songs, we're counting down the top 13 Halloween theme-ish, squeamish, regime-ish songs.
And Rihanna, if you're listening, hi.
Rihanna.
Just thought I'd put that out there.
I can say hi, Rihanna, too.
Sure. Go ahead.
I actually have met her more than once, so.
He said he could just say.
Yeah, you know what? Let me put a little cool factor in there. What's up, Rihanna? And this right now, the song we're about to get into is 3-6 Mafia.
Yeah.
We gotta take it to the south.
Late Night Tip.
Yeah.
Right here
on Shade 45. And we're back. Shady Records is in the building. Shout out Yellow Wolf, Slaughterhouse, D12.
I'm a little confused with the next song. Tech Nane. Did I know he spells his name? N-A-N?
No, it's a nine.
He
makes the I a nine.
What's that look like? Look how it's spelled.
Tech Nane.
Yeah,
Tech Nane.
Top number 13 spot. This is Tech Nane. Shout out to Tech Nane.
It looks like N-A-N-E. Tech Nane.
Tech Nane.
If we really called him that, I would get a...
Yo, Tech Nine is fucking ill. Tech Nine is fucking crazy. Yo, this next song we're about to get into right now is Tech Nine, Trapped in a Psycho's Body, right here on Shade 45. Hey, yo, and also, just to let people know, we weren't actually counting down. I kept saying we were counting down. This is not in any particular order. I wouldn't know how to count from 13 backwards anyways.
Me either.
So that's a lot to put on somebody's brain, to make them try to count down from 13 on back.
It's inconsiderate, too.
It's very inconsiderate. So I just want to put that out there for whoever made this list. And I also want to put it out there to the people that this was not in any particular order. These were just like 13 songs that we thought were dope for Halloween. So, oh wait, oh, that was, hold on, hold the phone. This just in, just realized we forgot one of the most important songs. Bad?
Yeah, this is Bad Meets Evil. Is this the first? No, that's not the first song that we did.
See, I told you we didn't know how to fucking count. This was not the first Bad Meets Evil song that Royce and I had concocted. This was
The second.
Anyways, who gives a shit? This was Scary Movie.
Produced by my man Reef.
Produced by Reef.
Happy Halloween to everybody.
Oh, I wonder why it's on this list. Because this was the one song that we didn't pick. Actually, I bet you there was 13 songs and you just threw this on the list as 14, didn't you? 13. Reef produced this song, people, and he wants you to know that. Okay? I want you to know that as well. My friend Bad wants you to know that.
Yeah.
And this was one of the things that sparked what was to come later, I think.
It was the EP before the EP.
It was the EP before the EP. This is kind of the origin of that. In a way, fuck the history. Man, let's play the song. Bad Meets Evil, Scary Movie.
Right here.
On Shade.
4-5.
What up? We're back.
And we're back. My name is Bad.
Oh, whatever.
I think I do have a Halloween story.
Hold the phone. Shit. Hold the phone. We have a Yellow Wolf Halloween story. Kids, get your marshmallows, sit around the fire. Yellow Wolf is about to tell a spooky ghost Halloween story.
This one is going to be good. I can feel it.
This is going to be great.
Oh, that's incredible.
So once upon a time, last week in L.A., when I climbed up the rafters and jumped off stage.
Is this a Halloween story, though?
Yeah, it's scary as shit.
Ah, okay. So that qualifies. That's all we need. We just need it to be scary.
So I climbed up the rafters. Ooh. I jumped out of the light truss, and when I landed on this chick's head, my dick flew out of my pants. So
that's scary.
Did it land in her mouth?
As I'm coming out of like almost being knocked out.
Fear, people, fear, fear.
I quickly shoved my cracker dick back into my pants, because I was on mute. And, you know, the volume wasn't up. So, that's my scary Halloween story. Watch out, kids. Trick or treat, motherfucker.
Right here on Shade 45.
You have just listened to a Shade 45 scary presentation. The Bad Meets Evil Halloween Countdown Special. Only on Shade 45.
The following is a Shade 45 special presentation.
The Shade 45 Spotlight. Putting the spotlight on new artists and music you need to know about before everybody else.
Hosted by Reef the Streets.
Exclusively on Shade 45.
Shade 45. This is the Shade 45 Spotlight with two very important, very special, special guests. None other than Mr. Marshall Mathers and Mr. Royce 5'9". And I am Reef.
Yes.
And you may also know me as Reef the Streets. We have Paulie clapping.
Yes, yeah. Sir.
That is a loud clap, dude.
Yeah.
Oh! Jesus. And we are here to spotlight a very important and very highly anticipated release, Bad Meets Evil, the return of Bad Meets Evil. Give it up! Give it up!
Yeah! Yeah. Woo!
They're back, people. They have an EP. It's called Hell, and you're getting to hear it for the first time on Shade 45 with special commentary and special insight that
it's
you will not
Hell,
get.
It's called Hell, the sequel.
The sequel. Yes.
Hell.
The sequel.
Hell, the sequel. Okay, yeah.
So, gentlemen, let's get right to it. This was a surprise to a lot of people. A lot of the fans were like, oh my God, they finally did it. Let's get into the genesis of Bad Meets Evil. Let's go back in time. Let's go back in time to circa, I'm going to say 1997, 98. Where did the Bad Meets Evil concept, how did that evolve? Where did that come from?
Well, let me see. Ryan and I, Rye. No, me and Royce met back in, when did we meet? 97?
97.
97, and he was actually opening up at, I think it was a place called the Palladium, and he was opening up for Usher. I hadn't heard or even knew about him yet, and he was opening up for Usher, and I had a booth where I was selling my tapes, the Slim Shady, the EP. And we ended up meeting later, doing a song together at a studio called Nations.
He had a line on the song that said, this is what happens when
when bad meets evil. And then I think we didn't know what to do with the song yet. We had just we just kept it. You know, I think we just, you know, we were local artists. We wanted to do a song with each other.
You didn't even have a record deal yet.
Neither one of us had a deal. We weren't sure what was going to happen to the song, but soon after that, I linked up with Dre, went out to Cali, and I wanted to use that song, but rework it with a different beat, and probably, I think we did, I don't know if we did all new verses or all new rhymes to it, but I think we might have kept a few lines or whatever from the original version, but I wanted to use it for the Slim Shady LP.
Now, pause right there, because before...
Thank you.
Before the Slim Shady LP actually came out, a Bad Meets Evil single did come out, circa 1998, for those that don't know.
Was that before?
Yeah.
Okay, so it was a, it was a piece of vinyl.
Yeah, it was a piece
company,
of vinyl.
A company called Game Records.
Shouts to Shecky Green.
So the 12-inch.
Oh, Lord. Big 12-inch.
The 12-inch. Featured a song called Scary Movies,
which was actually the B-side, or was considered the B-side. The A-side was Nothing to Do, produced by me, goddammit.
Both songs produced by
Reef
the Streets.
Yeah, so I have a lot to do with this whole Bad Meets Evil thing. So
you are the man, you are the fucking man.
I'm, you know, I try. Why don't we just go?
You're at least a woman.
Let's
at least.
Damn.
Comes full circle.
Woo! Thanks, Marshall. Let's start things off proper, like with the first recorded, released version of Bad Meets Evil as a unit together. Scary Movies, Shade 45, the Shade 45 Spotlight. We shall be right back.
You're checking out the Shade 45 Spotlight Special.
Exclusively on Shade 45.
Shade 45, the Shade 45 Spotlight. We are back.
Shades 45.
Shades 45.
Fives.
Bright out.
Royce
Bright
the five out. Nines.
Royce's the five nines.
And nineses.
Marshall's Mathers. Eminem's. We are back, and we just heard Scary Movie, the debut release of Bad Meat Evil.
Okay.
Bad Meets Evil. That was circa 1998. And of course, after that, or during that time, is when you got your record deal. You obviously started recording your debut album. And we get to the actual song that appeared on your album, which was Bad Meets Evil. And you were saying in the previous break that it was kind of like a mix of old and new rhymes. And
well, he didn't let me change a lot of my rhymes.
I didn't?
No.
What a dick.
He's like, no, nah, man, you're just, they straight how they are.
Did you guys at that point ever envision, like, hey, we should do a project or form like a side group or something like that of just doing a whole project together at that time?
With a piece of vinyl, that's kind of what that was. Not so much when we did the song for his album, but when we did the vinyl, it was kind of like, we'll do this as a group, especially since we did it separate from his prior engagement.
I think the reason, I think how it all ended up coming about and coming full circle like this, I think is even back in the day, I think me and Royce realized like we had a certain chemistry together on record. You know what I'm saying? It was, you know, the way we vibed in the studio together and in the kind of chemistry of just coming off of each other with rhymes and shit, like, you know, it was fun.
You know, without further ado, let's go into, from the Slim Shady LP, Bad Meets Evil. Bad Meets Evil.
All right, while this is playing, I gotta go take a piss, so.
Okay, we know how you have a small bladder. Shade 45, the Shade 45
Spotlight. Oh, it's peeing on Jesus.
Oh my God. Is this?
Get him a new shirt.
Damn. We'll be right back.
Spotlight. You're checking out the Shade 45 Spotlight Special.
Exclusively on Shade 45.
Yes, we are back. It is the Shade 45 Spotlight. I'm joined by Mr. Mathers and Mr. Bryce.
Yes.
Sorry.
That's me.
Sorry.
Royce the 59.
So, guys, we're back. We just listened to the original Bad Meets Evil track from your Slim Shady LP, 1999. Wow. And here we are in 2011. Mm-hmm. And now we are finally, the fans, everybody is finally getting a Bad Meets Evil project. And obviously the first question you've had to answer, and I'm sure, is what took so long?
What took so long for this to come about?
Absolutely.
Well, you know, there was a few years that me and Royce weren't speaking. And there were some issues going on that we had just internally, and some of them were public, you know, between him and I and D12. And, you know, that recently, within the last couple of years, got squashed and put to rest. And, you know, I really think that after the thing happened with Proof or whatever, you know, we really decided, like, this was stupid. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, to continue the beef. And Royce went on tour with D12. I think it was 2 years ago.
It was a couple of years ago.
Yeah, a couple of years ago, Royce had went on tour with D12 and you know, pretty much squashed it with them. And the guys had come to me like, "Yo, you know, we pretty much
we're good.
Squashed it with Royce. You know, we're good. Maybe you should holler at him." So, you know, I called him, and then ever since then, you know, we started talking again, and you know, then eventually it led to him having his the thing with Slaughterhouse, you know, and being in that group. And us having interest in that, and also, you know, me realizing that, you know, what a talent that he is as far as an artist and a rapper, and just wanting to work with him again. So, you know, we linked back up and just got in the studio and started making a few songs, you know. And it started out, there was no plan in the works. It wasn't like a thought out, "Hey man, let's get together and
I think
and
I
do
might
this.
I think I might have bought you something that I was asking you if you can get on for my album or something. I don't know how we started recording. I think whatever it was.
I think there was one song it wasn't you wanted me to get on.
Yeah,
I got on the song, and then I don't remember exactly how everything went down. But
we went back and forth on the third verse. We went back and forth on the third verse, and it was fun because we was like playing with each other's words.
So it was like
a fun process. So we just, with no direction, just kept recording songs like whenever we had time, and it just, we was liking the way everything was coming out. So.
And then we needed something to do with it. After we had a certain amount of songs, we was like, "Okay, well, what do we do with this?"
And this is over the past, what, like 7, 8, 9 months?
Or
less?
That many?
Five or six months, maybe, you know, of just us just kind of getting in and just...
I mean, it wasn't like we're going to do an album right away. It was just more just having fun, just working, staying sharp.
It wasn't consistent.
Right.
It was like I would be at the other studio doing something, and I would come up here just to check on him all the time because he always up here working, and it's like, it just happened, man.
All right, well, you know what? Let's get into the record because everybody wants to hear it. Everybody wants to know about how this all, you know, was actually made and the thought process that went into it. So without further ado, and this is a hell of an intro produced by Havoc of Mobb Deep. Shouts to Havoc. Shouts to Prodigy. Welcome home. Let's go into the intro of Hell.
Bad Meets Evil.
The sequel.
The sequel.
You're checking out the Shade 45 Spotlight Special.
Exclusively on Shade 45.
We are back on the Shade 45 Spotlight. And we are showcasing, we are showboating with Eminem and Royce da 5'9", better known as Bad Meets Evil. Important question here. Who decided amongst the two of you, "I'm bad, I'm evil"? "No, I want to be bad. No, I want to be evil." When was that decided?
When we did the first song. Because that's just...
It all spawned from that one line. I wish there was like a better story behind it.
Yeah, it's not a real good story.
Yeah,
it is what it is.
Nah, it's pretty anticlimactic.
But if you think about it, think about his content, and then think about my content, and then
it makes sense.
When we get together, we go even harder with playing those characters. Cause I got potty mouth when I rap with him.
Right.
It gets worse.
It gets worse
when they come together. It's like,
"Hey, whoa. Whoa!
It's like they kind of like in antagonize each other and like push each other to like do more like off the wall shit.
Not in a competitive way, or more like just
both.
I think that every time we rap, it's competitive. We're competitive by nature, you know what I'm saying? But at the same time, us being friends, it was more like the way that this whole thing came together. I think it was just more organic than anything. Like, what I mean is, it just, songs just kind of happen. As we started doing them, it was like, okay, well, what's your last line gonna be? Oh, okay, all right, well, I'll come off it like this. Or sometimes it was not even asking what the next line was gonna be, but just hearing what he laid, and I'd lay something, and then I'd feel like, I wanna stop here, I wonder what he'll do if I stop here. And then I would stop and let him, you know what I'm saying? Like,
so it's a totally different process from when you're working as independently solo artists, of how you come about and formulate a record and the song structure or whatever, because you guys are here together.
Yeah.
It's not sending files back and forth.
Yeah, no. No, we were actually, for every song, we were in the studio together, you know, and just, maybe not every song. There was a couple of songs where he'd lay a verse and then I'd hear it and say, okay, I'm gonna lay my verse. Or I'd lay a verse and he'd hear, you know, let him hear it. Like, what do you think if about this verse, and you come in for the second verse? Some of it was like that, but most of it, the majority of the work was done actually, you know, together in the studio.
And, you know, from listening to the record, you get that feeling that you both are here, present, and kind of pushing each other to do better.
Yeah, we wanted it to sound real cohesive.
And at what point, you know, as you started kind of getting back together and working together and kind of picking up where you left off a while ago, did you say, hey, let's make a real project?
How did that happen?
I don't know. I think that
we have a record company. So
right. But I think once we got to a certain point, it was like we ended up playing the shit for Paul and saying, what do you think we should do with this? And it started to make sense, you know, with the whole Bad Meets Evil concept. I started saying it in a line or two, he would say it, he may say it in a line or two, and it just ended up like
kind of
organically coming together, you know.
Interesting. Well, let's go into the second cut. Talk about Fast Lane real quick.
I like the word organic, so I'm gonna keep using it probably for the rest of this interview, because organic kind of means like it's natural, you know, it just naturally happened. So
I'm glad you know the meaning of it and using it.
I actually don't, but is that what it means?
I guess.
Organic, yeah. It means all natural.
Okay. I heard you use that word, Paul,
no,
a couple times.
It's no preservatives or hormones or anything artificial in it. It's all natural, organic.
Nothing artificial. I think that describes it perfectly.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to continue into the project here. First of all, the name Hell as the title of the EP.
The sequel.
That came from one of his lines, the very first song that we did together.
Which was?
See you in hell for this. He's evil, and I'm bad like Steve Siegel against peaceful. See you in hell for the sequel.
There you go, people. Yeah. Now you understand.
That was a quote from the Slim Shady LP, the Bad Meets Evil song off that. And from there, it just kind of made sense to, everything was put together and we got the songs, like, maybe not in order, but we kind of just had an idea of what songs we would use for it, is when we kind of just sat back, listened to it all, and felt like, okay, maybe we should call it this.
That it made sense as a
And then I was like, wait, we shouldn't call it this. Who's going to buy a CD called this? So then we thought, hell, the sequel. You know what I mean?
So for the real fans, they'll know.
Yeah.
The real deal fans. So let's go into Fast Lane. It's produced by Super Dupes and you, getting back behind the boards.
Indeed.
Excellent. Let's go into Fast Lane right now on the Shade 45 yes. Spotlight Special Bad Meets Evil. God damn it.
Spotlight. You're checking out the Shade 45 Spotlight Special.
Exclusively on Shade 45.
Shade 45, we are back. This is the Shade 45 Spotlight Special.
Yes.
Spotlighting, of course, Bad Meets Evil. We just heard Fast Lane. Now we're going to get into a song that makes complete sense about the two of you getting back together in a non-intimate way, of course.
There's so many eroticisms going on in this fucking interview. I think I might have actually said a couple myself, man. We got to go back and like really
listen. Evaluate?
Take some of this shit out. Or leave it in and loop it, one of the two.
Hey.
Oh.
Oh, hey.
Anyways, the next track is called The Reunion.
God damn.
And it is produced by Sid Rohms, who's actually two people, Joey Chavez and I. his man's name, god damn. And of course you also co-produced on this one as well. Again, I guess it kind of speaks to you guys kind of growing up, kind of putting all the bullshit aside.
Except it's not a very grown up record at all, is it?
No. It's but true. but these guys haven't.
It's based
really...
on a true story.
Yeah, this is based on a true story.
So, do you care to illuminate the people a little bit?
Nah, just it's based on a true story. So listen.
Okay.
Well, it's called The Reunion. Check it out.
It's called The Reunion. This is actually how we link back up. This is the true story behind how we link back up.
The Reunion on Shade 45.
You're checking out the Shade 45 Spotlight Special.
Exclusively on Shade 45.
Shade 45 Spotlight Special. I am Reef the Streets. I'm here with Royce the 5'9", Eminem,
yep,
and the Overseer, Poe Rosenberg. We just listened to The Reunion, and we're getting to the fourth track on this EP, entitled Above the Law, produced by Mr. Porter, who we know as Denon. And he produced the bulk of this record, and kind of describe his role in working with the two of you separately and together, and how his influence helped the overall development of the project.
Well, you want me to do it?
Yeah.
Well, Mr. Porter is kind of like he was kind of like the glue between me and Marshall for a minute. Like, me and him was working together for a while before me and M started working together. Then we all started traveling together, having a lot of creative conversations, and we just felt like when you got somebody that good in-house, like, you don't really need to look in a whole lot of different directions, you know what I'm saying? So, and we didn't know what we was doing. We wasn't going out looking for beats because we didn't even know we was doing a project. We were just cutting random, so he'll bring something to the studio. And
you were keeping it organic.
Yeah, we were just keeping it organic.
Yeah, and sometimes on some of them trips, he would bring his computer or bring beats with him, you know, put the shit on a CD, give it to me, give it to Royce, and, you know, we would just go through. And Nani, I feel like, Mr. Porter, I feel like he's definitely, it seems like he's rounded a corner. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's coming to his own. Not to say that he wasn't into his own already, but he's stepped it up to a whole different level with the shit that he's doing now. That's like fucking crazy.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know,
I would agree. So, Above the Law is the track that we're about to listen to next.
Yes.
Let's go. Let's get right into it, shall we?
Check it out. It's Above the Law.
The Shade 45 Spotlight Special, Bad Meets Evil. We shall return in a moment.
Blue Light Special, Bad Meets Evil.
Spotlight. You're checking out the Shade 45 Spotlight Special.
Exclusively on Shade 45.
All right, we are back. The Shade 45 Spotlight Special. I am Reef, a.k.a. Reef the Streets, with Royce the 5'9", Eminem, Bad Meets Evil, From Hell.
No.
No.
Hell the sequel.
My bad. I'm thinking of that movie, the slasher Jack the Ripper movie, From Hell. Anyways.
It came out 10 years ago.
I know. I'm dating myself yet again.
Hey!
Hey! Now, this next track I actually heard in its infancy, so to speak, and I guess it talks about what you were telling us before, Royce, about how you and Denon were working together independently, kind of sketching ideas out, and I remember you playing this song for me. I think it was at the Not Afraid video shoot.
Oh, you're talking about I'm on Everything.
Yes, good. I'm on Everything, and it's a crazy Mike Epps sample, and let's talk about it real quick because it deals with substances, and how did you get everybody to sign on? So
this was the record that Royce brought me. This was the one you brought me first. This was the record that Royce brought me first, and he played it for me, and I heard the hook, and I liked this verse, but I was thinking, like, how in the fuck am I supposed to, what would I say on this? You know what I'm saying? So I had to just, like, throw caution in the wind on it. I had to just sit with it for a second, and like, oh, okay. Let me.
Was that difficult for you? Because the song deals with substances. It deals with booze. It's dealing with, you know,
everything.
Liquor, weed, everything.
I just had to put all of that shit aside for a second and just approach the record how I would approach it. You know what I'm saying? And not try to overthink it. You know.
Mm-hmm. Well, wait a minute. I don't do everything anymore. Yeah, fuck that.
I guess Royce, when you initially came up with this record with Denon, did you think that Marshall was going to get on it?
No, and this is one of the reasons why It's like when it's like I learned this when I first started working with Slaughterhouse. I'm not gonna push myself the same way I would when I'm doing myself. Like if I'm cutting random records, because that was random. Like that's the reason why when you heard my first verse, it was like I was playing so much, and then he came in on the second verse and murdered me so bad. So it's like then when we did the third verse, it was like we was pushing each other so much. It gets entertaining. It starts here, and it goes up.
Right,
and I love records like that. Had we come to the table together, he would have brought more out of me. You know what I'm saying? That's why I'm glad we did everything.
Half your verse wouldn't have been
Without further ado, I'm on everything.
Yes,
Bad Meets Evil, Shade 45. Let's go.
You're checking out the Shade 45 Spotlight Special.
Exclusively on Shade 45.
We are back on the Shade 45 Spotlight. I am Reef. He is Marshall. And he is Royce.
Royce is on Twitter.
And Royce is on...
I'm not on Twitter.
Royce.
I promise.
Royce is a Twitter addict, by the way. Why don't you just give out your Twitter right now?
Follow me at TheRealRoyce59. The Real Royce all spelled out, the number 59.
And that's R-O-Y-C-E for you illiterates out there, a.k.a. our loyal listening public. The song Kiss, which I was a little shocked by the title, considering you're not kissing each other. Let's keep it funky. But produced by Bangladesh, you know, a guy that produced the Millie for Lil Wayne. Let's talk about the genesis of that record real quick. And, you know, what's it all about?
I think one of the reasons that record came about was after listening to the EP and listening to everything we had. I think, you know, Royce and I wanted to do... Like, we had so much fun doing some of the records, like I'm on Everything and, you know, the back and forth and whatnot, that we wanted to have at least one more record like that, where we, you know what I'm saying, like where we just kind of went in there and just kind of spazzed out and just see what happens. You know, what if I say this line? What would you say, you know, after I say this? And the best part about it is kicking him out the room, letting me say my line, and then have him come back, hear it, then I go out the room. You know what I'm saying? It's the like I don't sit there and listen to what he's laying while he's laying it, and he doesn't do that with me. It's kind of like we want to surprise each other, and it's like, okay, like I'll come back in the room, listen to what he did. All right, give me a second, you know, think of something, go in there and say it. You know, he'll come back in. Oh, okay, you said this. All right, I'm going to say this. And that's, you know, that's where the fun comes in when we start doing that kind of shit. So
it seems like you had a lot of fun overall on this project.
Fun guys. They're fun guys.
Yeah, you know.
Fun guys, though, that bad and that evil.
I mean, you know, with Bad over here on Twitter all the time, you preferring to play Atari or Donkey Kong or whatever, you know, I don't know how any work gets done around here.
See, Twitter is bad. Atari and Donkey Kong is evil.
Right.
Well, there it is.
And I constantly got shit I'm doing, man. You know, I'm trying to go for that Donkey Kong record. So it's like in between that, I take a break and I record. And then I go back.
Go back and
take another stab at it.
Hit the joystick.
Oh! Shout out to Weeby up in this bitch.
No doubt. Let's listen to Kiss from
Hell. The sequel.
Hell. No, I didn't say From Hell, like
Hell,
that was the title.
Colon, the sequel.
Spotlight. You're checking out the Shade 45 Spotlight Special.
Exclusively on Shade 45.
All right, we're back.
We're back. And we're about to get into more from Bad Meets Evil. And this song, I guess this is like, reminds me a little bit of, you know, your past record, Marshall, where the music was like stadium music. It was described to me as by somebody that you really get that kind of like you're in a big ass venue and the lighters are up in the air and you're on stage and you're rocking on that type of level where the music just sounds big and dramatic. And this song is called Lighters, speaking of lighters, featuring Bruno Mars. And kind of give us a little insight into the record. And what do you know? You co-produced this one too. What do you know?
As well as Bruno Mars.
Yeah.
Yeah, Bruno Mars is incredible, man. Like, yes. He's, you know, ever since, like, I think the first time I heard him was on the B.O.B. record. Mm-hmm. And then from there, I started, like, really kind of doing my research and, like, really checking out shit that he's doing. And the dude's an incredible talent. You know what I'm saying? Like, the way he sings and some of them notes he hits and shit, he's fucking sick with it. So we had the original beat. didn't have him on there, but there was a kind of a guideline chorus, or how would you say it? Kind of like a rough chorus on there at first. Mm-hmm. There was a rough chorus on there, and me and Royce laid our verses to it, and basically just went to him, approached him, and see if he would do it. You know, was hoping that he'd be down to do the record, and he was. So, and then he came in and he rewrote some things and put his own twist on it, and
because it's a little bit more serious than some of the other records, which are kind of just more like, you know, lyrical and fun and kind of like not shock value, but you know what I'm saying?
A lot of this shit is, I'd say a majority of the EP, the bulk of it is just us having fun and just wanting to go in there and kind of just do some, like, let's not stick to the basic, you know, the typical album structure, you know, of the way everybody else is doing things and try to be, you know, go out of a way to do things. Let's just have fun with it first and see where it takes us. And then some of these records came in a little bit later, and this one in particular, we did feel like we don't want the EP to be all that. Mm-hmm. And also, I also wanted to be able to, it was kind of my thing where I wanted to be able to show the world who hasn't heard of Royce yet and hasn't heard him rap. I wanted to be able to kind of help showcase that a little bit and his ability to write about not just bars, not just spit punchlines. I wanted to be able to showcase some of the depth that Royce has, and also, you know, a song like this and a song like Take From Me, and just show that there is, you know what I'm saying? Just
versatility,
and also has some substance to the EP, so that,
and it's, you know, organic.
There was a little something for everybody on here too.
And it's organic.
And it's organic.
So let's, without
it's orgasmic.
Let's pause. Let's go. Lighters featuring Mr. Bruno Mars on Shade 45. Bad Meets Evil on the Shade 45 Spotlight Special. And this is a very special, special. Let's go.
You're checking out the Shade 45 Spotlight Special.
Exclusively on Shade 45.
Yeah, so we're back on Shade 45. Woo. That was Lighters.
Woo.
Royce the 5'9", Bad Meets Evil, featuring Bruno Mars. And let's talk about a little bit about that chorus, man, because the original idea to Lighters, when we brought it to Bruno Mars, was how the chorus is saying a sky full of lighters.
Mm-hmm.
We wanted to say a sky full of spiders. We were like, listen, man, just
like hear us. Like a Halloween record?
Bruno, just hear us out, okay? We got this record.
It's arachnid. It's an arachnid-based hip-hop record.
And then he wasn't with it. He didn't like the spiders thing, so then we thought, okay, what about this? A guy in some diapers.
Guy in some diapers.
So he didn't like that either, so then he just made it a sky full of lighters.
Yeah, he's pretty good, that guy.
Yeah, that guy's all right, man.
We might put the spiders version out, like a Halloween remix.
With accents.
Yeah.
Is that going to be like the fist pump remix?
No, what are you talking about? Come on, man. No, it's
spiders. A sky full of lighters.
Spiders, man.
Spiders. An eye
full
of spiders.
Fist pumping remix.
An eye full of spiders. Yeah, we're going to do the house version, too.
All right, we're approaching the end, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm. The end is near.
The end is near, but we approach another contribution from Mr. Porter. This is called Take From Me. Anyone care to explain that one, guys? What were you thinking there?
I think every album or EP or whatever needs that one record that's just self-explanatory when you listen to it.
Yep.
That's one of those ones you just put on and listen.
And it's definitely, it's addressing some things that have happened as of recent, you know? And that's all I would really say about that. I mean, the rest of the record is self-explanatory when you listen to it. And I think that a lot of people just kind of maybe wanted to know our take on some things and how we felt about some things. So we expressed it in this record.
Tell them how you feel. Let's take from you, pause, and listen to the song. On Shade 45, the Shade 45 Spotlight Special, I am with Bad Meets Evil.
Yes.
Woo.
Spotlight. You're checking out the Shade 45 Spotlight Special.
Exclusively on Shade 45.
We are approaching the end. Everything has a beginning and an end, an alpha and an omega, and we are coming to the conclusion of this EP, which it's almost an album, guys. Come on, we're talking 9 songs here. You can add a couple.
Hey, man, more bang for your buck, homie.
You know, maybe we can fit in a reef beat. You know, I brought a couple things, man.
Can't do one more, man. That'd make it 10, and then it might as well be an album, so sorry.
Gotta go.
Jesus. Gotta go, man.
Jesus.
Sorry, I got shit I'm doing. I gotta go. Wait, oh, Donkey Kong, wait. Fuck.
Damn. Well, before you guys get out of here, we have the final song, Loud Noises, featuring Slaughterhouse.
Slaughterhouse!
Shady Records 2.0. There's a lot going on with you guys, with this project, the label. The one thing that struck me, because this kind of came out of nowhere, the Bad Meets Evil project, and the fact that it's just, you know, you seem like you're in a good place, happy, doing what you want, working, and just giving the fans ultimately what they want, and kind of talk on that, and just, you know, forgetting about the music business and, you know, the big record company stuff and everything else, and just about working, having fun, and where your head is at.
One of the things that I think that the whole purpose of this EP was, me personally, was to say, all right, people, like, to the public, me and Royce have got past our differences. You know, we're working together again. Here's something that I feel like was kind of long overdue and maybe even should have took place back in the day.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that something like this should have came out back when, you know, we first started doing songs together.
With me, yeah. And go ahead.
And no doubt.
No doubt, son.
And but also at the same time to get people excited about the group, Slaughterhouse. You know what I'm saying? And to kind of, like, here's this, let's get this out of the way, now let's get the public excited about Slaughterhouse.
Slaughterhouse!
Which is why it's the last song off the EP, and it's also because we want to leave it fresh in the public's mind. And this is another one of those beats that I was talking about from Mr. Porter that where I just don't know what he was thinking when he made this beat, you know? Because it's so just off the wall. That
it's like a challenging beat to rap on.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But everybody really, really, I never heard Joe Budden's rap on a bounce kind of beat like this.
Yeah.
You know, like, you could tell people really had to work.
Joey has depth. He has depth to him.
Yep.
Depth.
And that's another thing that was cool about this record, was to just, everybody just get on it and go as hard as they can.
Was everybody here for that, together?
That's for me to know and you to not know.
Thank you.
That's basically just for you to not know then.
Ultimately, I get that.
Okay.
So
I could not think of a better way to answer that. That is probably, out of all the questions I've ever answered in my entire life, that actually could be the absolute best answer I've ever given.
Takes a lot of time to come up with that.
In the history of my answers for anything, that was pretty fucking good. That guy's good, that Evil. I'm telling you.
Hey, Evil. I will neither confirm nor deny.
Exactly. That's what I've been trying to say since I got here, man.
At the end of the day. Hey, Bad.
This is what I've been trying to say since I got here.
Yes. So before we get on out of here and with this final song.
What if I was worse?
Bad Meets Worse?
Yeah. Because it easily could have gone that way. And something else I want to say, it's been Bad Meets Evil for this long, right?
Sure.
Since back in the day.
Since 98.
Wouldn't we have met by now? Why do we keep meeting? Because you only meet somebody one time.
No, because this is just the result of Bad Meets Evil. This is the result. It'll always be the result.
Of when Bad met Evil.
Bad meets Evil, and here's the result.
Bad is meeting Evil.
Bad met Evil.
And here's what they did together.
Bad meet Evil.
Pete and Repeat were walking down the street.
Mm-hmm.
Pete got hit by a car.
Mm-hmm.
Who was left?
Pete. Repeat. Wait, what? The worst part is I know that joke.
I hope so.
All right, well, any quick plans for the summer? Stuff coming up?
Go to the beach, go to the mall, hang out. Do a little bit of hanging out.
Short sets.
Short sets, mad short sets, son. Yo.
What do you mean, show-wise?
I mean, you know, obviously we have a Slaughterhouse record that's going to be coming soon. Marshall, I know you're always working. This is your chance.
Royce has an album coming out.
That's right.
Yes, I got an album coming out July 26th.
Which is entitled?
Success is Certain.
The sequel to Death is Certain.
I wouldn't say the sequel.
Didn't I produce a song on Death is Certain? Yes, I did.
Yes, you did.
Certainly.
You did.
So we got the Slaughterhouse album is coming. The Yellow Wolf album is coming. Back in the studio with D12. So just working, man.
That's great. Well, I want to thank both of you.
We got a
bad
movement.
Some bad, movement. Evil, thank you. Lousy, worse.
We've got a stillment.
I want to thank you for letting us put the Shade 45 spotlight on the boss, Eminem. And Royce, congratulations. I'm very happy that you guys finally came full circle,
thank
360,
you,
and to give the fans
180.
This special treat. Mm-hmm. Shade 45, the Shade 45 spotlight special, Bad Meets Evil.
It's all in the shady tree. Get it?
Get it.
Check
on June.
For any information, shadyrecords.com, Eminem.com, badmeetsevil.net, I think.
Follow Royce at?
Follow Royce.
The Real Royce 59.
Follow him.
And follow me on Twitter. Holla back.
At Eminem. And you are at?
I am at NYC Reef.
And I am at Bunyan71.
Yes.
And Royce, what's your website?
I don't have one.
Okay.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Twitter.
You can neither confirm nor deny that.
Listen, Twitter is my website. All right.
And you better believe it, because Royce is on Twitter.
Yeah.
That is for real. Thank you all. And
to all a good night.
And to all a good night. Yes.
Yo, everybody listening, man. I just want to thank you for coming out, man.
The Shade 45 Spotlight. Put in the spotlight on new artists and music you need to know about before everybody else. Hosted by Reef the Streets.
Exclusively on Shade 45.
It's also because I have a pink slip for you.
Oh, yes.
Happy anniversary.
It's a scary day this Saturday. And of course, I've been talking about it all morning. And of course, the biggest white guy on the planet is on the phone right now, right?
Pause.
Hey, it's Casper.
What's up, man? Mr. 2.8 million. What's up, man?
What's cracking, homie?
Eminem, what's up, man? Yo, you know what's crazy, man? What the hell are you doing for Halloween, man? What kind of costume you got on right now?
I'm going to dress up as myself.
Get out of here, for real.
Go trick-or-treating. Yeah, I do it every year.
You really go out there and, like, you know, you trick-or-treat with your own image? Like,
mm-hmm.
People actually believe.
That's usually what dressing up like yourself implies. But
wow.
And they never guess that it's me. When they put the mask on, they think that it's not me. Like, oh, that ain't him. Fuck out of here. He's not going to wear himself.
Oh, my God. Are you happy, sir? 6 years, man. 6 years.
Damn, 6 years old, man.
Running strong, man. You know, you're killing it right now, man. You got your own channel, killing the airwaves. All the popularity, all the craziness, beef. You started so much beef off of this channel. Aren't you happy?
I'm happy. I'm always happy when there's beef over our station.
Yes. Jesus Christ, man. Shout out to the whole world out there. The whole world's tuning in. And then, of course, we got the Twitter questions. Everybody want to know. We want to make it quick because you're a busy man. You're about to go trick-or-treating. We want to stop you, you know, for 5 minutes. Is that possible, Mr. Eminem?
Yeah, but hurry up because I want to get a lot of candy tonight, dog.
Sugar rush.
Yeah, Jesus Christ. 6 years into the situation, we got some questions from Twitter. Can you answer them real quick before you disappear?
All right.
The new Rihanna album. Is there a part two to your record on the new Rihanna album? Can we hear from your mouth?
I can neither confirm nor deny that.
Next.
But we could actually talk about the important things, like the Cowboys are fucked up right now because Romo's hurt.
Damn. Okay.
Woo!
And for my fantasy team, he was on my fantasy team, and now I'm kind of fucked. So, I mean, if we want to get into that, I mean, that seems like the matter at hand that we should be discussing, because I'm completely fucked. And as a Cowboys fan, I'm fucked too. Although Matthew Stafford is coming back, and I'm also a diehard Lions fan, so I have that to look forward to. But, yeah, we're kind of fucked right now. And I had to get Kyle Orton, and I had to give up Hakeem Nicks.
You didn't have to.
Did you do
gave
it?
Up Hakeem Nicks?
Come on,
yes,
man.
I had to. I need a quarterback, and Kyle Orton's good. Like
he is. He is.
Yeah, he's.
Wow.
Got some of the highest stats, man. But that hurt. That really fucking hurt. But anyways, the part two to Rihanna's that thing, that other thing that's going on. I'm not sure. I just can neither confirm nor deny that.
Okay, but there's one thing that I can confirm, and I heard it the other day at G-Unit office. I didn't steal it. It didn't get Bluetooth. I heard that.
Yes, you did.
Oh, okay, I did. The you and Lloyd Banks record, amazing.
Oh, thanks, man.
Amazing. And you guys went in on some traditional going in on a record type shit. It wasn't like verse, hook, verse. It was like spazzing, then you come in spazzing, then Banks come back spazzing. Can you talk about that record? Because Banks, you know, he's hype right now.
Well, I just want people to hear it. I think that Banks fucking kills it. He did his thing on it. So I'm excited for people to hear it. And I'm glad we had a chance to actually do something, because I know deadline was approaching and we were really trying to like scramble to get something done. So.
And a lot of people, and I like to let everybody know, it's on the iTunes version of his album. So everybody can enjoy the downloading situation, just order it. And other than that,
or just get it from Who Kid.
Oh yeah, can I get permission from you so I can play it right now? Can I do that, Reef? Can M tell me I can play the Banks record?
Go ahead, man. You know you have it. So
ooh, you hear that, 50? He said I could do it. Yeah, right.
That's all you are right now.
What are we to look out for Shade 45, man? Are for the future? Because this is the anniversary. A lot of people want to know the future of this channel. Is there anything big you're trying to do later on in the future?
I can neither confirm nor deny that.
Yeah.
Smart guy.
That's a very political answer right there.
Yeah, it's a good answer when you have no answer. You know what I mean? Like, that shit always works. Just pull it out. It uses.
Hopefully you got one answer for me. This is the movie world. I just saw your Entourage. Is there any future movies? Everybody's waiting for, like, you know, the next movie with M, like, you're controlling. What's up?
Yeah, it feels like people keep asking, like I get asked that question a lot, but the same answer I keep having to give them is kind of like I'm just waiting on the right script, you know? And there's a couple of things that have seemed a little enticing recently that it is possible that we could get into, but again, I could neither confirm nor deny.
Yo, this guy got a lot of answers today, man.
At the end of the day,
this guy's crazy, man. Can you give me an answer on a tour, like a future tour for Eminem?
Starts tomorrow.
Wow. Serious?
Nah.
You're jerking me right there.
Nah, I'm kind of just doing I'm doing a lot of spot dates, like here and there, like different places and shit. But we haven't launched it. We don't have any plans in the near future right now to go all out with a full-fledged tour or anything like that. I'm kind of just doing things like different cities and dipping in and out here and there and shit is basically what I kind of been doing. Yeah. But right now, I got a show in Brazil coming up next week.
Uh-oh. Oh, boy.
Oh, my God. Jesus.
Wish I was going to that one.
I love Brazil, boy.
Yeah, I've never been, so it'll be...
Can I give you
an experience?
Can I give you one of my children I have over there that you could babysit until?
Oh, just one of them?
I have like three, four, but I just want you to babysit just one. I kind of named him your name too, Menemem. You know, he's a very nice kid.
The fucked up part is you're not lying.
I'm not lying either.
It's not an exaggeration. You're being completely serious right now.
Speaking of kids out there, the No Love record, man. Are you representing all the kids that's getting bullied in high school and all that? Can you explain that to all the kids out there tuning in? They don't give a fuck about their parents?
Well, I've kind of always been, I guess, I don't know, a spokesperson for that particular subject. And as far as, like, you know, just conceptually with the video, we felt like that's kind of what the song was saying, was like, you know, kicking somebody when they're down or somebody being bullied or whatever, you know, picking on somebody or whatever. So we kind of just came up with that concept and went with it for the video.
And I know you're waiting for Lil Wayne to come out. Are you going to be there when he comes out? Is that going to be a surprise? Like, when he comes out, you going to be out there?
Yeah, I'm going to be there, and it's going to be a surprise.
Wow.
Don't tell nobody.
I won't. Yo, thanks, man. Yo, F, man. Thanks for calling, man.
Definitely looking forward to Wayne getting out, though, man. I can't wait to hear what he comes up with next. So.
Well, he's got like 20 hits out there while he's locked up. I'm afraid what the fuck he's going to do when he come out.
Yeah, man. It's going to be real interesting.
Jesus Christ. So, and of course, 50 Cent, the biggest question, the future with 50, man. Anything I need to know that I don't know already?
Nothing that I wouldn't have to kill you after I told you.
Okay, I'm just gonna get that out the way. Shout out to Reef. His mask is selling out this Halloween. You know, it's a big thing for Reef right there, man. Jesus, man. Any Eminem masks out there before you go?
Any what?
Eminem masks. You didn't do a deal with the mask company?
No, I didn't. I didn't. But I just go to the store and I buy them.
Oh, okay. Thanks for you know. I'm
just, yo, just do me a favor though. Try to keep that under your hat because I don't want people that like if they see somebody dressed with an Eminem mask on or whatever. Mm. I don't want them to know it's me.
This guy's
so
crazy.
Just kind of we'll just keep that you know on the low.
Yo. Before you go, I just want to say thank you for giving me the greatest job on the planet, man. Shade 45, man. And just don't ever fire me. Is that possible?
You didn't get the memo this morning?
Ah, shit. For real? That's what that was? Sorry. I thought it was a check, man.
Hey, man, we're 6 years old. We're cleaning house. It's time to get some fresh blood in here.
Help, man.
Get your needles. Get your headphones. Get the fuck out.
Man. Good looking on the call, man. Happy Halloween to everybody out there. I did it. I told you to call my phone, and I missed the call, but I found the call up on Halloween on Shade 45. Is that cool,
man? Thanks, man. Trick or treat, bitches.
Can I get a blah?
That's really gay.
Yes, it was. Thanks, man.